Being a woman and a leader in Kajiado is not really very easy. Not in Kajiado, as a Maasai woman.
I guess that is what I would.
And being a woman and being a leader, what do you require to be able to get into leadership? But I only need to speak about two. What do you require to be in leadership? I will speak about three things that you need to have. One is your well-being, health. The next is education, and maybe resources. Now, looking at the roles that we have in the current setup, licha yale yetu ya kuosha vyombo, kulea watoto, kuchunga mbuzi, kuchunga mume, kufagia kanisa, kufanya maombi, sio? Nje ya hayo yote, sio? So, Jay,
she has a family.
About being a woman and being a leader, how much, looking at our health issues around Kajiado, how much time do I have to give to my other leadership roles? But in the same as your health. Of course, we know that as a Maasai woman, you are guided by cultural beliefs. And with these cultural beliefs, there are also the new trends that come. There's HIV. There are sick people in the home place you need to take care of. I'm an custodian. Why are we told we cannot go into leadership? It is because we already have a lot of tasks at hand, including that of taking care of the people and people's health at home. Who are sick? You need to provide health care for the family, sindio? So then is leadership going outside the homestead? Is it a priority for me being a woman? Is it a priority? Or this leadership, yenye iko ndani ya boma, is really enough for me to kukaa hapo, tayari imenijaza mikono. So, and bounded by cultural beliefs, do I rather become a leader mwenye taenda kwa county, or I'd rather become a leader who promotes the issues of early marriages and the issues of FGM? So here are the choices a leader has to make. And as a leader and as a woman, do I tackle the issues of leadership at the county, at the national level? Or do I look at the usual issues of high mortality rate and look at issues of midwifery in my neighbor? Nasikia struggle. Yeah? Nasikia struggle, sindio? Nasikia struggle, niende kule. Ama haya majukumu ya health within family, within the neighborhood, within where I live, are also pressing issues. Then I go to education. Because those issues of health are issues around the Maasai woman, around the Kajiado County, which are also pressing issues, looking at the issues of access, even nationwide, and the issues of access in Kajiado. Then we go to education. We know that most of the times when we are asked which pastoralist woman, which Maasai woman will do this, unajikuna, do I know one who has gone to school? but that one, I think she's working in Nairobi. She can't get time. Do I know any other one? The rest are what? Housewives, the rest are illiterate, the rest are
semi-illiterate,
and the others are teachers. And most likely nursery school
teachers.
Sindio? Sio high-fly. Kwa hiyo mama wengi ni nini? Because if Naini decides to marry today and he's in Nairobi, he will probably marry a teacher. I'm not saying a teacher. listen to the explanation. Where is your name? And probably, because he didn't want to marry a housewife, take the teacher closer home at Loichokchok next to DEB primary school so that she can be taking care of the home and DEB what? Primary school as a teacher. Hata hata concentrate, atakuwa anaangalia ng'ombe zake. So the master is, being a leader and being a woman, and a woman in education, did we have the privileges, japo juicy, until the recent years, when Masais would take their girls to school? And even so, after class 8, as a woman, and you are too loud, they think you have matured for marriage. That is a sign of maturity and readiness for your home. See you? You get circumcised, and if you're not getting circumcised, in the school. Ukimaliza study, tunasema? Semeni yokitu, in the school. Umemaliza nini? Na form 4, ukimaliza, umemaliza nini? As far as they are concerned, they don't know what else you are looking for. So, as a woman leader, there are these issues of education that you need to tackle. And even as yourself, we have very many women leaders, maybe teachers, maybe just other leaders. Do they have time to further themselves? Of late, 5 years after the last elections, 2007, we've had women who have gone to a senior training center to enroll for secondary education, women. One of them being a counselor called Jane Saroni. At least so that she can, you see, she was a counselor, an elected counselor, a nominated counselor. She decided to go to school so that she can be able to contest come 2013, you know, when they said that the constitution will only allow people who've gone to fourth form. And also looking at her gaps in terms of performance at the county, at the county council, what we are calling a county assembly now. Looking at her performance, she decided to go. But how many of us would leave your children home, would leave your domestic cause, have even the money, because you're not going to sell your husband's cow and go and pay school fees when the children don't have school fees? How many of us are going to go out of our way, create time? And this woman who was going to this school at a senior was in Ibisil, coming all the way from Ibisil town, to have time to go to classes. And how many of us have resources? Even if I'm not going to school myself, I take my girl. Even if Baba so and so says, I don't want this girl to go to school. We don't have money. He wouldn't say I don't want. He would say we don't have enough to take her and boy here to school. So let boy go, let her stay at home. At least we can get a few cows from her when she marries off the chief's son. And how many people, even though we have ngapi, ile ya watoto kwenda shule, the Children's Act, cap 586 of the laws of Kenya, the Children's Act, sijui kama imekuwa repealed. Why? How many of us have the courage? What happens in our churches where most women are in, especially the churches in Masailand, the churches that are AIC, PCA, such are the churches. What happens when our girls get pregnant? How do we apply this law? What happens with the custodian of education and the custodians of the Children's Act? Me as a woman leader, how do I relate? Because these custodians, the chief and the rest and the leaders, the informal leaders we were talking about, also are beneficiaries. Because if so-and-so has a beautiful daughter, what's wrong with the chief getting a good wife from a good family, from a good, from a relatively wealthy family, even though she hasn't done for four? What is wrong with the daughter of a wealthy man going to the chief's home, where the center of power, Niabo? What's wrong with that? What's wrong with being associated with a counselor, even though the girl is young? You've heard of a case of a girl who was married off, and then some lady, then I was working with the Kajiado Women Advocacy, called Eva, went to the chief and the council. When they got there, they were locked in themselves. And what had happened is that the girl was married off, and they were unable, the man who had married off the girl, who the girl was married off to, was not patient to wait. Initially, I told you, these girls are taken home. You wait until the girl is mature enough, then you can have her as your wife. So he wasn't patient enough. He got some two young friends to open the way, for him. He didn't do it himself, but he had people to open the way. You get it, eh?
Yeah.
So that was our issue then. We rushed to the counselor, then Ole Moya, very powerful in Moi days. Nothing happened. The woman was locked herself. We were torn between getting her out and doing what for the girl. So what resources do we have to apply to these issues? As a woman and as a woman leader, is it myself I'm looking at in terms of education? Is it my children? Do I have the supportive mechanisms who are also the chiefs, the councillors, and any other government officials, even for the case of like Isinya, all people in Isinya are like ex-police. It is where I come from. I think they were recruited at one time, all the men were like, this is an ex-police, this is an ex-police. I mean, how do you? Yeah. So those are the issues. Then again, the issue of resources. The issue of climate change now. Is it, what am I going to do as a woman and as a woman leader? Am I out there to support the women who their men have lost all the cattle to put something on their table? Who their women, who their children are out, plus their mothers during drought? They are harvesting sand at the river. They are busy harvesting sand. There are no more cows. Am I out there to give consolation to those who husbands move to town, you know, men, and they are loving themselves? When it is too tough, you are left home with starving kids, starving parents, and they go out. And they are apparently doing what out here in Kajiado town and Ongata Rongai town and the Kiseria town? They are probably trying to get some kind of jobs, maybe get something to send home. Maybe, but in all that, they also get lost into the new developments that come around with such liberties that are going to go to town. And most of them can also decide, okay, we don't have any more livestock. They can decide to sell land so that they are able to do this and that. But we have often seen that the sales of land, because we depended mostly on livestock, but then now it's not really, I can't say it's not viable. It is. It's only we are not innovative enough. What do? We sell land. When we sell land, if you have never owned 20,000 in your account, tomorrow you have 15 million in your account, what happens to you? Do you know how to handle this money? You get confused. All the plants you have go down there, the drain. So in all this mix-up, where is the woman? In all this trying to get herself resources, does she own land? She's a woman leader. Is there one day she's going to sell land and do blah, blah, blah? First, because she doesn't own a title and she cannot be registered in a group ranch. So where is the woman and where is her leadership? Nationally, women generally in local authorities up to last year, local authorities, CZ County, were 15.8% councillors nationally. And then there was the provincial administration, highest representations were DOs at 19%, followed by deputy PCs at 8.7% in the last 5 years. And then there were executives like the ministers, Kinangilu were there. They were 15%, 11, blah, blah, blah. And then the representation of women was 10, in the 10th parliament was 10%. So where were the pastoralist women? Oh, now I'm saying pastoralist because we were looking at the larger picture, but where was the Maasai woman then? If we have a Maasai woman nominated, elected, blah, 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 we never had. The very first Maasai woman we had elected here, the very first woman we had elected here was elected in 2002. She was from Ongata Ngai. She was called Ruth Wakapa in the county, and she wasn't even a Maasai. She was elected from a cosmopolitan ward. We've never had one who was elected. But why? Why? When you are asked to say something about Kajiado or something, you know, one of you said, Maasais don't like being led by women. Was it Maasais women leadership not valued? Women leadership was not valued in Kajiado. Is that true? Is that true, or it was only that women did not present themselves for leadership? And when we are talking about leadership, do we only limit ourselves to the leadership in politics, to the leadership in the council of elders, to the leadership in chiefs? Or we are also talking about the various leaderships that I said in education, in health, and in terms of giving livelihoods to, is it that leadership too? So if this is the national picture of what we have in government leadership, what people recognize as leadership, because these other roles are not looked at as leadership, why are Maasai women then not in politics?
So there are still many things that women are not doing so that they can be recognized. For example,
let's talk about the political parties. Do they have political parties? Why don't they have political parties? Or why aren't they really active in political parties? Because of the assumption that politics is a dirty game. Because again, political parties initially were supported by individuals financially, isn't it? So they never had the resources to put themselves forward to head political parties. And for now, political parties, see, they are, you know that they are funded by government to some extent. But still, that does not close the avenues of people who have resources to control them. So most of the political parties were controlled by men. And did women have social groupings? Do women in your place have social, like they can go out? The social groupings that made decisions informally only to go and rubber stamp them in a political party meeting. Are you seeing those meetings? Okay, you hold a meeting during the day, then later in the night a few people meet, they make the decisions, they draw up a list, tomorrow it is presenting the list and that is final.
Unless I'm married women.
Unless unmarried women, but do they also have access to those? So women lacked that. And then the other issue is that women, the real power brokers, she talked about power brokers. The hidden, was it hidden powers that you said they are power brokers? Do we have women who are power brokers? Women, there are very few power brokers. And as leaders, when we are just about to get there, because they are these power brokers, if you really don't do something, then your powers na za kwenda mbele zimekatikia wapi? Zimekatikia hapo. That is why during nominations, for example, when you are thinking, oh, she's so popular, she'll get the ticket, you find that those people you thought will take tickets did not. How many times have you thought, what? Who did they nominate? What? And you're wondering, from where? Yeah? The people you thought you'd see in the list are not there. Why? Because the power brokers walifanya kazi yao na wakaleta sister, auntie, nani, and they have all the reasons to do that. Personally, I was supporting a few women. A few women in 202, seven women across Kajiado County when we were working for Kajiado Women Advocacy to vie for council seats. And out of those, only one came through, the one I told you about. But as we went through that process, again in 2007, 2006, and again women came together and they thought they could vie for those seats. Unfortunately, none of them got the seats. And that was not an issue of Kajiado, but I'm just telling you how much we've tried, you know, to bring on board the pastoralist woman, because as she had said, we share a lot of cultures together. But I personally also vied in 2007 as a county, now we are calling them member of the first issue was perceptions that Maasai communities are not ready to elect women. Do you think there's that? Is that a perception or it's a fact?
It's a fact.
Oh, Maasai are not ready.
No, not only Maasai, I think even the other tribes.
Okay. Although it is still a new idea to have a woman as elected as an MCA or as a member of parliament, most Maasais are actually awake to the fact that a woman can be a better leader. Even in discussion, not even a better leader, an equal leader. Even in their discussion circles. But the perception that Maasais are not ready to elect a leader, a woman leader, is mostly propaganda that is peddled by the educated, the elite.
And
Maasai
in this new dispensation, do women seek county and parliamentary seats?
Maasai women,
no.
Do they seek?
No.
Why did they seek?
They are afraid.
Oh, you hear how the constitution is interpreted? I asked in this new dispensation, do women seek county, you know, county MCA and parliamentary seats, Senate seats, governor seats? They said no. Why?
They have the woman
who has interpreted the constitution. Which men? Are they not say Baba Zetu? Have they said no to you? Did they say ah? Hawa watasimama hii kwa sababu katiba. Nani amepeleka hiyo mambo ya katiba itafanya watu wako wabaya na hawafai wako na kiti yao? Nani amewasomea? Ni men wale
wasom.
So that you don't take up their space. Because I don't know, I didn't hear her say, but at one point I think justice is only for the strong. Yeah. Yeah, na kusukuma mpaka huko kwa kona. Ndiyo. Justice. So women, Maasai women, though they didn't have their own Maasai woman being a parliamentarian or an imihi or a woman leader, they had leaders. In Olkejodo County Council, back in 2002, before 2002, we asked the county council to nominate, to co-opt six women into the council. Where we did it as a lobby group. We had a very active lobby group here in Kajiado. So then I was young. So they said, because we were loud mouths, no, we are going to get elderly women, respected elderly women. So when they look around there, they find a young woman who looks like she will shout in the council and bring her own very good knowledge or bad knowledge here. No. Tutachagua, yes, the chairman agreed. So he took the debate, they agreed. They co-opted six women, none of them could write their name. And they said, these women were also proactive. I always remember one called Mrs. Soikan. And she was really good, and she knew what she was doing.
should come and try to talk. Then they created another hindrance. They said they are co-opted leaders, no one should talk. So we went again lobbying. Now what do we do? Because you cannot talk here. So we said what they would do before the assembly, we had an office right opposite the county council. If someone knows Kajiado, you know the SNB block, the Arid Lands block. They would come before, they tell us in Maasai, then you write what she wants to tell, and then they go and give a friend counsel, a man. So that if that issue interests him, you know, umempatia, lakini sio wewe utasema, si ndio? He can decide to put the paper in the pocket and fall. So women sit. So depending on who is taking the message to the people, to the Maasai people, it is not true that they are not ready to elect women leaders. It is true that they know of Ngilu, they say even us, we need our own. But the people who take the message out there, and the people loudest, are the men. And the men that we were told there was patriarchy, and it depended on class and I don't know what else. So it is not just any man. And then again, are women able to provide security against aggressors and livestock? Me as Josephine, as a leader. You know, I was surprised when Naiti decided I'm the mentor. I said, how did he arrive at a woman? I thought you would get a morale with How do people provide security? What is needed in provision of security that a woman, me as a woman leader, cannot provide?
Vijana.
Okay, what do the vijana do? And what do the leader, not the vijana, what do the leader do? In case there's insecurity here, what happens?
They hire the goons.
What happens?
She would mobilize the youth.
Is a woman able to mobilize youths and mobilize security apparatus? What do they use to mobilize security apparatus? Guns? What?
Hangers.
What do they use? What does a leader use?
Money.
They use influence. If I am a woman leader, if now I pick up my phone, I decide to call the OCPD. See, I'll just call. If I say there is insecurity, would they respond?
Yes.
If I said our cows, the baby one, and I call someone in Mashuru and say, have you seen like there are some cows? Would I get that info? So how comes a woman cannot provide security?
You also need to have your resources, yeah? Like when you call an...
So when you are a leader, you don't have resources. A woman leader cannot have resources.
The UN didn't
bow. So a woman leader has no power. Power in a new workshop in a network of workers.
Yes, she does.
Okay, what else is used? So what is stopping her from, you know, following her community and, you know, preventing them? Sikule tulikuwa tunapigana inani wa East hapa, juzi tu, when Ngilu and... what was her name, the MP? Ule alitolewa? Wavinya Ndeti? Alikuwa nito? Si Wavinya Ndeti. Alikuwa nito hivyo?
Wavinya? Wa kumempi wa wapi?
Wa hapa Machakos.
Wavinya.
Wavinya Ndeti. When she decided, this Maasai are jokers. He Portland yetu, he sijui kwanzia wapi, you know, she decided to demarcate and there was conflict, and that conflict, see, Ajana, it has always been there, eh? But now this time she decided no, because the counties were coming into being. She wanted the resources. And the people of Kajiado are saying during the boundary reviews and blah blah blah, were saying now we want our boundary to go. There was the initial agreement of the boundary to occur. She came out and she said no, and Ngilu was there. It is actually the women from Ukambani who flawed the men from Kajiado, the warriors, the very brave ones, yes, brave somewhere. The very brave ones, they were actually flawed by the women of Ukambani until, there was a bit of conflict, there was a vehicle ban. You remember all this case, eh? Wasn't it the women leading their forces towards an enemy that was Maasai? We move from that. Are women seeking public seats of loose morals? Because wakati nilisimamu huyo, uwe, inashiba hii. Kama natutukana kama si consola. Hauna tabia mzuri, kakiri hauna tabia mzuri. Sia tumesha watukana, yani sijua imekumbuka uli watukana si kutukana. Anamakiu kutukana si kutukana doing that, you said something. Even by way of walking, you are insulting them. Look at her. And she's walking. Yeah? By way of walking, you insulted them. By hata ukujua umewatusi. Because you didn't wait for this elder to finish and you had an interjection. Because they want to lie about things. There's a time we were doing a demonstration about our people being killed by KWS. The chief stood up and said, we cannot take a demonstration to another district. And it is the women who are doing, because our men were busy, were busy doing whatever they are doing in towns, and the young men were going with the cows to the Kenya to the parks at night. The young men, they were arrested, they were being beaten. Wanatolewa nguo wanafuja nyumbani bila nguo mchana, you know. So we decided as the women, no, wazee samta tuambia kitu. The chief stood, mwezi chukua demonstration hapa Kajiado district mpeleke Nairobi district. Is there a rule that says so? So by virtue of standing up and saying, we can even take it to London if we can go. And we indeed went, yeah, as a group of women. And they said, go there. They told the boys, if you follow these women, you go there, you'll come in tatters. You'll be beaten. All these women, I don't know, will do what? Let them go. And they were now like, you know, telling the boys, let the women go alone. But you see, they misinform the communities. And another one actually told me, you want to lead this demonstration because you want to be seen on TV. I told him, but I've been on TV many times. You know, I don't need to do all this. So, are these loose morals? Are women seeking public office or leadership? Are they loose morals? Because when a woman gets... When I came out and said I wanted to buy, and this happened to Paris the other day when we were going around. If I walk with Naini, I want to spoil their son. I am sleeping with the son. If I walk with this girl, this one, hey, now, is this woman the agent of this girl? She's walking with this girl. If I walk with her, I want proud to take her. I am spoiling women to be like me. If I walk with my age, George could pass for my husband. It could be clustered in that same group. I am taking people's husbands. Who are you supposed to walk with?
Alone.
And they've been working. The man is not subjected to such.
Ridicule.
Just about to finish. So you can see the handles that a woman has to endure. And if your husband is supportive, what also do they say? Then, like the issue of our member of parliament, I'll give her experience because she's here. Whether she's married to an outsider or a local, she's not here. Because she's not here, I'll give her example. I mean, she would talk it right here if she was here. Whether you are married, and if you are married,
to who?
Mm-hmm. And are you barren? Do you have kids? Mm-hmm. With who? Are they your children? Your husband's? Are they your husband's kids? Huh? So for her, we crucified her. Why? Because she was married to an outsider. An outsider is a Maasai from Narok. An outsider was not a Mzungu, Kikuyu, Somali, what? He was a Maasai from Narok. And they said, why should she? We gave her to Narok, to the people of Narok. If she wants a seat, she should be contesting where? In Narok, not here. Yet the man who has taken her to court today is a man
who is married to a mzungu.
What?
Mm-hmm. And for us, the Maasais, we are like, whoa, he is a man. He is a man. He went out. And as usual in our tradition, he came along with something. You know? Why isn't it? Yeah, why isn't it something that we went to Narok and came along with a Maasai man?
Because you're a woman.
Why isn't it something?
Yeah.
Don't they say in Maasai that a man, that a child that who goes out and comes home with something is a good child? So why discriminate now? If two children have gone out, one, she's strong for me, then that woman must be very strong. Umeenda ukakapcha ukakuja. You know? And you will not come with something bad. And if really, indeed, the Maasai were looking at the benefits of having this girl went to school, she equally brought a man who has gone to school. And everything that she's going to do, she's doing it in her community where she was.
What
significance is a woman's reproductive role in her political aspirations? Sasa juu nini hii wanasimama kwa jukwaa juu wewe ni mwanamke. Huyu ni miradi ataenda ama ni kuzaa? Do we give birth every day? Do we give birth every day?
No.
Do we get periods every day?
No.
No. Periods ni kitu ya kunikataza kwenda hapa mpaka pale. Ama kufikiria ile kitu nilikuwa naongea. And they say it in a meeting full of children, full of men, full of women, full of your children. Even if I was going to be pregnant, and most women get into leadership at 35.
Why do they get
into leadership at 35? Most women have attained a more serious. You can see like the difference between me and Patita and the at least there's a simama na mtu hivi, and you know they've gained the confidence, maybe the posture kidogo, and have gained a bit of respect. That is in the traditional setup, the way we think. Sindio? Such that even if I walk to the DC's office, it's not the same way she would walk into the DC's office. They might tend to take me seriously. Even if she has, that is why our new nominated senator, she's called Ruth, from Naisula Lesuda. If she walks today a plane with Kenyatta, she cannot be thinking. She can only be going to do what?
Amongst
why? Because she's young. Why didn't they mention? If it was me, if it was Paris, they wouldn't even remember she was in that flight. So those kind of remarks need to be countered well by well-prepared responses and by showing examples of how women are not handicapped by their reproductive roles. Examples are those of pregnant and lactating women herding and watering their livestock, fetching firewood, cooking and taking care of the whole family. Because that is even more physical, sindio? More difficult. Lakini tumeona wa mama wangapi akona kuni, akona mimba, akona katoto kengine hapa, na anaelekea like this, they ask for a woman's name to do blah, blah, blah. It is not always the woman who can take herself there. It is now these others who open up, you open up the space for, because by having that other, you will always come by through other means, and then you make the number larger. So for me, that is about being a woman here in Kajiado and being a woman leader. I know most of the aspects are the same elsewhere, but the challenge is not small. Yes, we have a court case. It all began with being cast, that we were going to do a cast. That did not materialize. That we are going to tell our young sons not to follow women. Where is women leadership taking us? That did not materialize. That we were in the wrong party, not supporting the Maasai cause. That did not materialize. And yes, now we have a woman member of parliament, but we are in court.
vote counting is on. I've attended these sessions, but only in four polling stations. And we will get to know the results. It would be a pity if we lost that for the women of Kenya and for the women of Kajiado East and the women of this county. And of course, the youth who really gave us a lot of support, both men and women. And I lost even to the Kajiado people. Maybe it is again for the Narok because their son had been sat on, but I don't know. Thank you.